remaining. And we're back for the second game in our show match here between Power Rangers and Burden United. This show match is organized by Esports Against Addiction, a good cause here, guys. Make sure to all check them out at esportsagainstaddiction.com. They have great initiatives, and this, you know, it's just such a great organization. I'll go check it out, please. You will do me a huge favor by doing that. And well, let's just go into this match here of this best of three, of which the winner will get 500 euros. We are Swiss DC, the casters, at least. We came here to guess this match. I'm Sander, with me is Zach. Zach, man, you're still happy to be here?
Oh, yes. I'm so happy to be here. I'm casting my favorite team, Power Rangers, against Burden United. And Wisp Tiny picked up. Predictable, as always. The first pick, I could have guessed it. It would have been a Tiny, or at least a Chaos Knight. But Wisp Tiny is nothing to, you know... Nothing to snide at. This is a very potent combo, especially against Winter Wyvern. The Cold Embrace just sets up the Tiny, if anything, just to unload that magic damage nuke that they have. But still, Bounty Hunter is really good against Tiny, as well as Io in the early stages of the game. Just that Janata and the Shuriken Toss as well is very good.
But on the other way, as on the other side as well, you know, it's kind of hard to be a Bounty Hunter versus Tiny and Io, because if they find you and the Evelyn's touch you, You're dead.
Yeah, pretty much. Bounty Hunter's strength gain is not very good at all. Like, being an Invis hero, like most Invis heroes in Dota do not have a good strength gain at all. So yeah, I think Bounty Hunter just dies here. If he's not careful. And I think this will be either a J... I think this will be a J4 Bounty Hunter. Like, Gorek was sensational on that Winter Wyvern last game.
Indeed, he was just playing so well. What do you think? What will the Bounty Hunter do this match?
The Bounty Hunter will be roaming quite hard right now on the Wisp and the Tiny. Definitely slow down the momentum of the Tiny and how, you know, and the pace that Tiny gets the farm and starts to grow and starts taking towers quite easily and taking heroes really quickly. Bounty Hunter will be a nuisance, and Bounty Hunter leaves an option for Power Rangers. Like, they can get a greedier carry, they can get a Medusa, a Spectre, and like a mid, for instance, our Shadow Fiend would have been a really good example, but Shadow Fiend is banned out. And we have the Bristleback picked up right now, and Bristleback is very good against the Tiny and Io as well. The masses of physical damage that Bristleback outputs, especially with Tiny and Io's low armor at the start. I think they both have zero at the start, maybe one on the Tiny, and Bristleback loves it. Bristleback has that minus armor nasal goo, as well as the Bristleback spray. It's just OP against Tiny and Wisp. They can't do nothing to nuke him down.
Well, essentially, well, they can nuke him down still, though. Bristleback, he is strong versus them, but he is still able to be blown up, and they just need more, and if they can get in front of him, the combination will do so much damage. Mm. But yeah, it's... As a Bristleback, you're fairly okay versus an Io and Tiny.
Yeah.
But yeah, this game, I don't think Power Rangers will be as caught off guard as last game with the Io. That's a burden there. At least they have something right now to really go with the Io. Like, Tiny-Io combination, that's strong. Last game, they missed something for the Io. He was doing really well on his own. No way to deny that Nuis was playing awesome on him. Storm Spirit. But just an Io is not enough, and they failed it. Radiant team band. And some fast picks here. Whoa. Both teams setting their way.
Undying so strong right now in this meta.
And usually he doesn't get this far though.
Yeah. Remaining. He usually prioritizes a first pick or a first ban as well.
5 seconds
remaining. Just a tombstone is just so good against Wyvern and Bounty, especially with their low HP pools as well as their little armor. And,
yeah, and the
I'm not
DK,
sure. If...
Oh man, that's.
Yeah.
All that minus strength for the enemies is just so tasty, and you're yourself getting so much HP. It's so strong in the early game, and you just having the Io Tiny plus on dying, this already means that your early game is fairly secured here, as well as your late game.
Yeah, and Undying will be a core right now. I'm not sure if it will be solo safe or solo offlane, but this Undying is definitely a core with the Witch Doctor Wisp.
Yeah, I think it's gonna be the off lane here, and they might just pick something else on the safe lane. It should be a strong safe lane, so they might be looking at maybe a Viper or a Razor even. Since you're gonna have a dual lane on mid, so you're gonna try and win at least two lanes here, and just picking up a strong laner there should help them out a lot. So I'm thinking again, Razor or Viper for Burden.
Razor's pretty good here because firstly, he's an agility hero and just has a lot of armor as against the Witch Doctor ultimate and the physical DPS from the Tiny, as well as the static link as well. So Razor could be a good call here, but I do prefer the Viper. Just the physical damage as well as the ultimate that can be used on Tiny. And we see a Darkseer. Carry Bristleback.
So it's going to be in...
Yeah,
how are they going to do this? This is going to be position one Bristleback. Okay, that's we've seen that one before though.
I've seen Ditcher play it a few times. I think it's a pocket strat for PR, unless this is a position one Storm Spirit with the Bristleback mid. That's always viable. Get an early bottle on the Bristleback, that's... remaining.
Yeah, it is probably better to do that than to put Storm Spirit mid versus an Io and Tiny. That's a little bit dangerous.
Yeah. I wouldn't say that Power Rangers have much aggro try potential. And not let the Darkseer solo safe lane against the Undying, because I know the Darkseer would prefer that matchup. Like, Surging and Iron Shelling around the Undying. Darkseer would prefer that matchup, but I think that whatever could be comboed up with the Witch Doctor right now, Darkseer doesn't do too well against because of the Witch Doctor stun. Cask. But we have to wait and see, really.
Indeed, we're going to see what Burning is going to go for. And they're going to go for Skywrath Mage, so this is going to leave the entire carrying to Mind Control on the Tiny here.
What, Tiny? Like, Mind Control played support last game.
Yeah, he played the position for Naga. I'm not completely sure if it was supposed to be a position for, or they just got kind of torn apart with the first engagement and just went along with it.
Yeah, so come with me, Tiny, now. I switched it back round. And Ditcher on the Bristleback, so this will be a mid Bristleback, I believe.
Yeah, Jekyll was position one last game on the safe lane, and I like this more just because Storm Spirit is pretty susceptible to getting killed by Io Tiny in the early levels. So it's good to get him away from there and put someone else middle. And they're most likely still gonna safe lane it on mid here with... what I'm going to assume is... Oh, mid, I mean. What I'm going to assume with that the Winter Wyvern is also going to be there to help him out.
Yeah.
Or maybe... Well, I don't think the Bounty... I'm just looking forward to see how they're going to roll with it. And let's just go and introduce the teams here. On the Radiant side, we have Power Rangers. But then we have Cheshire Cat on the top lane playing the Darkseer. J4 is going to be playing the Bounty Hunter. Dirty Ra is going to be playing the Bristleback. On bot, we have Jekyll together with Gorek for now.
Yeah, and on the side of Burden United, we have Skywrath Mage being played by Mind Controlled. We have Mormy, is that right? Meowmy on the Witch Doctor. Yeah, we've got Big Gnome playing the Undying, and Nahiz on the Wisp, and Come With Me playing the Rockman, Tiny.
They're doing a little bit of hiding here beneath the trees, looking for someone to come there, but Jack was being very careful right now to not get spotted here. It's kind of like a standoff. Come With Me is pinging that somebody might be coming here. Oh, he shows himself. That was too fast. Yeah, no one. PR is not going. Yeah, PR is not going for this bot rune. They're going to take the top rune.
Yeah, they committed 5 for it, though, just for the Wisp bottle.
Essentially, simply put, it's worth it. Just having your bottle makes your mid so much better.
Yeah, so this is a mid Wisp and Tiny with Mind Control just floating around, I think.
Yeah, he might just go top. And actually, okay, they switched around. Come With Me is now on Tiny.
You got excessive pings coming out right now. And we're unpausing.
So is Mind Control going to go solo top here? Okay. So Come With Me together with Nihis are going to be middle. And where did his... Okay. They're playing the safe. They're making sure that the bottle gets delivered, so he walks back all the way to his tier 3 there. Now, Komomi is a little bit alone. He might just get a poke here, but they're not able to even get close to killing him. Because Nia should be able to come in here and maybe even give him a little bit of a bullet charge there.
Yeah. And I think Jichiro's going to have a good time. Oh, well, I say that and he just takes an avalanche right in the face.
Indeed. Well, top here for mind control. He should be okay versus a Darkseer Skyref. You know, you have your arcane bolt to just quickly nuke down the creep that has Ion Shell. That said, for Cheshire Cat, there is no way to really keep him out of XP range without either dying yourself or, well, you're just not able to do that. He even pulled in and he's just going to get his creeps all the way back to his own creep wave here.
Yeah, I don't think Jackal's going to be finding much on the bot lane, especially with the Witch Doctor right clicks, as well as the Undying Decay as well.
Yeah, he's not really able to do a lot here. They're getting zoned out quite hard.
Yeah. I've still got no worries for Jackal, though.
Like, last game he came back brilliantly, but we'll see how he does it on the Storm Spirit here.
Yeah, they've also got Gorek babysitting Jackal as well, and I think that should be fine right now.
We're just waiting for Undying to get level 3, get that level 2 tombstone, and then might just dive underneath the tower, get off a good cask, and you might be seeing some kills there. And oh no, on mid, Dirty Ra was able to pick up Gon with me here.
On the tiny? How? Like, they've got the bottle on Wisp, right?
Over aggression, for sure. They just get Quill Stack, Quill Stack, Quill Stack, then they die. That's just how it goes.
Yeah, DigiRL's played it really well this game. Last game he got soloed by the Wisp, that's safe to say. He's playing really well against his dual lane. He's got 10-2, he's beating the Tiny on CS right now, and he's even picking up some runes. Bird and United are doing nothing to stop Power Rangers from getting these runes.
Yeah, at the moment they're not really able to do that anyway, so that's pretty much how it's going right now. They're able to zone out Dirty Ra a little bit here with the orbs, but it's not as potent as it was before, and even J4, he's still just lingering around here. They do find him here with the orbs.
Yeah.
And note it's a 2-versus-2 situation here. Well, Bot just keeps on being pushed in here. Jackal got some more harassments on top of him, and he just gets heals up here with the cold embrace.
Yeah, DigiRL's playing really ballsy right now, and it's really paying off. He's just getting those Quill stacks, and here we go on the bottom.
Oh, there is the totem coming out. Jackal is in a lot of problem. He's taking a lot of damage, but there is going to be the Cold Embrace keeping it there. He gets another DK on top of him, but how long is he able to stand versus it? Well, not too long as he dies here.
Yeah,
Gorek will be able to live.
Yeah, and come with me. He's been left alone here. DigiRL, there's three Quill sprays right now. DigiRL's going to go deep here. Come with me, he's underestimating it. He's throwing out an avalanche. One more kill spray. Oh, it was just short.
And he will be able to live here. Good avalanche there, just in time. Well, they're going to go on mind control here on top. The double iron shells here. He's getting a lot of damage, and mind control will take a fall here. It's just a question of when. And there you go. J4 kills him off. Oh, Dirty Ra in middle. He's going to get tossed. He's going to get a knees on top of him, but that's going to be all.
Yeah, I'm not sure if... Yeah, DigiRL is going to go back to base right now. He needs to fill up his bottle, get some health and mana. And until then, I think he'll look around and on top and bottom and see if he can get some kills now. He hasn't got any levels in the Viscous Nasal Goo yet. I think that's probably the correct build against Tiny and Wisp. But I think his kill potential right now, until he gets that Warpath or just a level, he's not that strong.
He should be fine though. He is getting ahead in XP versus Kong with me as well as Nihis. There's going to be the avalanche. There's going to be the toss back towards the tower with Dirt Ra. He just starts walking towards bot. He's getting some damage here from the tower as well. The orbs start hitting him. He still has his stick. He has bullet charges as well. Oh, there's going to be another toss. Do they have an avalanche here? Oh man. Yeah, they're going to get Naomi in here. They should be able to get this kill. There you go.
There was five Quill Sprays on the Tiny. That was really unlucky for Dirt Ra.
Well, they're gonna go in here again. He's taking a lot of damage. He needs one more poke. Well, Gorek is gonna get, well, thrown back here, and now he is alone for just to get a double kill on Kong with me. He has had to die for it, but this is worth it for now. Is Gorek able to survive through this? He does buy his boots on time. He gets some wards. He's just getting items while he's getting chased down here. He gets a clarity. He will die.
Yeah, that's not very good for PR. They just gave away three kills when they were well ahead, like four kills up. But it's unfortunate for PR. Never mind. Oh, here we go. Jackal's found the Witch Doctor on the bot lane. The casket's out. Tombstone down. More decay stacks on Jackal. Jackal, run!
But there is going to be Gorek already. He has the Golden Rays ready. They're going to try and turn this one maybe around on Burden or just run away.
Yeah,
he chose for the
latter.
Suddenly the game is exploding all the way through. They're stacking her up in the Ancients to get Dirty Rust a little bit more farm later on.
Yeah. Oh, here we go.
Going with me. He's getting a lot of damage here. He's going to get the Avalanche start on top of J4. He's getting really, really low, but they're not able to kill him off. Because Dirty Rye, he's gonna go after Kong with me, and he blows him up with the quill stack there coming out. A double quill stack.
Oh, they're, yeah.
They're actually.
He's found the wisp.
Oh man, he's kind of stuck here. They're just gonna keep on running after him here with the Ace Rune. He just needs one more hit, and there we go. He dies. Ooh, Dirty Rye. He's gonna get two tower hits. Yeah, he's gonna survive. He's gonna survive. Quite easy.
Yeah, well played there. He knew the limits of his own hero, and J4 took the big, massive nuke in the face, and he still lived just about, which enabled DHRR to get a few quill stacks up and get the kill on the Tiny Wisp. Well played.
And so far, really, all the farming has been happening on top. Mind Control with 42 less hits. Cheshire Cat has 38. They've been the one who have been getting a lot out of this.
Yeah, we don't really see many Tinies getting the grow at level 6. We usually see the 4400. Do you think that they're having the 6...
No, they're actually going a lot for grow. It boosts up sheer toss damage. They tend to go for 2301.
2301.
Yeah, that's the most base. That's the standard build.
That's the standard build.
Yeah, that's the standard. Like the normal build. You only really go full on Avalanche Toss if there are a lot of stacks. And J4, he gets found. He's going to be able to dodge this Mystic Flare there.
He's been playing the game way too long. He knew that the Mystic Flare was just going to go there. And we have two hordes right now from both teams just sat right next to each other.
Oh. Litra taking some damage here from the toss, but he's just going to start running at Come With Me. He has a Nasal Goo now. Come with me, he's trying to turn this one around, but he rips a little bit there on the Avalanche. He's gonna get another quill stack on top of him. They don't have the track just yet.
I think we're gonna see an early Crimson Guard coming up now on DHRR. He's got the Ring of Health as well as the Stealth Shield. I think that's probably a wise decision against Witch Doctor.
Oh, they're gonna go after Dirty Rod. They do get off the silence as well as a dust on top of him. There's gonna be the toss. He's getting low and they're able to kill him off. Nihis gets the kill. Well, he's actually fairly low himself.
He nearly got a couple kills then.
And they see it. They see the stack here. They know it's there.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that PR are gonna move over there soon and take that stack.
They will try to, but. They will need to actually. Big Num. Ooh, Splinter Blast on top of his face. Are they able to? No, they're not going to go aggressive on top of him. They are afraid of the turnaround potential as well as the totem that's already down there on bot.
We see a level 5 up on the Wisp now. As soon as they get that level 6 on the Wisp, I reckon they're going to look around the map, probably get some pickoffs on the Bounty Hunter as well as the Winter Wyvern. They really need to null PR because I think late game, PR win here.
It's gonna be hard. You can never count out a tiny IO combination in the late game. They can just take your entire base in a matter of a heartbeat.
I do agree with you there, but I think that PR's draft really is suited for dealing with the Tino. The Tino? That's a mix of Tiny and IO.
It's your new little word there, but yeah, they do have indeed good things to deal with it.
Yeah, as well as the Bristleback and the Winter Wyvern Curse. As well as Vacuum Wall.
Poor Storm is also fairly good to get out someone in the back. And he's going to get Asian Steel. Here's going to be Tombstone as well. He walks straight into the Mystic Flare and he's going to get killed. Golden Rays keeps him just on the edge there and he's just going to die. Bignum is, however, taking a lot of return damage and he will fall to Gorek. One for one trade and Gorek is able to just TP out from here. He doesn't want to fight up versus a full HP Skywarf Mage here.
So, in your opinion, what do you think about the core Skywarf Mage?
Well, actually, I don't know if you have this seen the Max DPS series by on Navi, but it does the most DPS, but that's really, really biased as well as certain items and those kind of things. But it can actually work. You have an incredible amount of burst damage, and it's really strong in the mid game.
Yeah, and that big stack from PR's been taken out by Ditch RR. He's got that Vanguard up, and oh, here we go now. J4's in trouble.
Orbs hit him, but they don't have any detection on either the Aya or the Tiny here. Well, come with me. He just walks straight into Cheshire Cat and J4 here. He's gonna get tracked up. Niska is there. He doesn't have to relocate just yet. He's almost level 6, but it's not close enough. Now there's gonna be the Winter's Curse on top of Niska. Come with me. He gets off an Avalanche.
Ooh,
is not able to return.
Low.
Well, on bot lane, they get a return kill. Onto the Jackal here with Big Nom.
Here we see Gorek and Witch Doctor fighting it out right now. Gorek's alive. He's alive.
He still was able to live through that for now with the Cold Embrace from the Devour physical damage, and he will just start walking away now.
Yeah, the poor little Ice Dragon's hurt right now. Okay, he's fine again. Yeah, Gorek has been playing outstandingly on this Winter Wyvern. We've seen him in the last game and in this game pulling off really good Winter's Curses. That was the first one of the game, and it was really turned around that fight. Well, I wouldn't say turned it around, it just made that fight in general.
Indeed.
And here we go now, looking at the net worth graph and the experience graph. PR.
Oh, let's wait that for now. They're gonna go after Gorek here. Are they able to find him? He goes on top of the hill. Yeah, he is able to just survive through all of this. But come with me is still looking. Dutra, he gets a concussive shot on top of him. There's a DD on Bignum. Are they gonna dive this tier 1 tower for him? Well, they are. There is going to be on the back. He's come with me with an Avalanche Stars Mystic Flare combination with the Ancient Seal there as well. Just too much damage for him to withstand.
We got a Winter's Curse up in 22 seconds. That, especially with Burn United's sort of thing right now, they're 5
minutes. Oh, Avalanche, Toss, Gorek, he is dead. They get the tower as well. They're looking for more here. Can they find J4? They get the orbs off. Do they have any thing to detect him with right now? It doesn't seem so.
Burton United just doing the 5-man mid pub strat right now. This seems to be paying off. They're getting these kills right now, and PR have been caught off guard.
Yeah, they're grouped up all the way through. Getting the creeps now before they leave it. And they will leave the Radiant jungle now, unless if they can actually find Jackal here, but I'm not gonna think they will.
Hmm. Yeah, and I think the Roshan potential on PR is possible. I'm not so sure about the Burden United. Is with the minus armor, the Nasal Goo on Ditch RR could make Roshan quite easy.
Still, they don't really, apart from actually the Bristleback and the Cold Embrace, to keep somebody alive and able to tank through Roshan. Also, their lineup doesn't really excel that much in physical DPS.
Yeah, but they could definitely fight around the Rosh Pit with Winter Wyvern and Storm Spirit, as well as Darkseer. These heroes are really good at fighting around the Rosh Pit, and PL stack's been spotted out.
Again, but would he be able to take this one now away from them? Well, that's it. Actually, it's also quite dangerous to fight versus a Skywrath Mage as well as a Witch Doctor. If they can get off good ultimates there in the choke point, it really depends on who goes in first and then gets called out.
Yeah, we got the magic rune now on the Bristleback. We have the haste rune up. I believe Dichoraz is going to chase down everything right now.
Yeah, they are, however, looking here to defend this tier 1 tower. Bignum gets down the totem. Are they going to try and focus this one for now? Yes, they are. The totem is going to take a fall here. Mystic Flare is not that good. They are actually able to just go after it. Well, there's going to be the Shuriken Toss stopping the Death Dwarf here. Jackal, he's taking a lot of damage. He's able to just zip away from Come With Me while Dirty Rob picks up Nihis. Oh, this fight is split up in two ways. Mayomi is trying to fight up versus Dirty Rob. He gets Asian Shield, but they were still able to kill him up. The Shuriken Toss hits 3 here. Decay on Dirty Rob. They're still following Big Num here. Oh, they're diving behind the tier 1 here, and they're gonna call this one a day because it's too far in. Dirty Rock gets all the rest
here. Like that mages.
Oh, Gorek blown up by the Avalanche Touch combination here. And now Dirty Rock, he gets concussive shot on top of him. They have a toss. Well, they'll use it. There they go. He's tossed all the way back to the creep wave. He's gonna get close to mind control here. Shuriken is doing lots of damage, but Dirty Rock is able to get him out. There's gonna be the Avalanche, and they're gonna kill off Dirty Rock. No, he is just alive, but there's gonna be the toss. Yeah, kill him.
That was such a long, drawn-out fight there. But Dicharra just quilling and quilling and quilling, and it's just set up loads and loads of kills for PR. It was unfortunate that Jackal really couldn't fight there. He got blown up at the start of the fight, and he was really low, and he got away really quickly. I reckon if Jackal wasn't focused then, and oh god.
Yeah, that is that's the blink there coming into play by Come With Me.
Yeah.
He just blows him up. This is the part where you're... Oh, what? They're gonna go after Gorik as well. They're not done here. There's gonna be the avalanche. There's gonna be the toss. Do they have enough damage to kill him off in time? Yes, they do.
That was a... That's a... Five people went down from PR, right? Badgers and Wyvern came back into the fight there. So that's five heroes from PR going down.
Yeah, this is the strength from a Tiny here. Just able to blow up all these squishy targets on the side of PR.
Hmm.
They will have to look out a little bit more now. J4, they're looking. They're gonna find Miami here. Oh, TP out. 3 seconds, 2 seconds. They should be able to get the Shuriken toss off quite easily. And yes, they will. And Miami, yeah, he's gonna die here. There's no way that he can stand versus these two.
Yeah, and that's a track kill as well. Very nice.
Did he TP to the bot tower where just his entire team TP'd? And that's why he had such a long TP timer there.
I reckon he's probably quite mad at his teammates right now. I can imagine. I know I would.
Be mad at your teammates for you being the one to TP, that would be quite odd though.
Yeah.
But yeah, they're gonna go for the tier 2 push here. Start laying in some damage with Come With Me. Knees is close as well as Micro. He's just spotting out, seeing if somebody wants to go and rotate in. But as it seems now, PR, they're just content to get a little bit of a push in here on mid with J4, but...
Dicharra's
well
cleaning up a stack.
On top, they're pushing in the tier 2 there, and indeed Dicharra's taking the Asian stack here. But they will lose their tier 2 here for sure.
Yeah, Jackal with the DD.
Yeah, on top PR is indeed pushing in.
But on the bot lane.
Are they gonna get this in time though? Because bot lane is already fallen now. They don't have relocate. Oh, they do actually. They're gonna relocate into this fight here. There is gonna be the totem drop down. Jackal goes for aggressively. Oh, the Winter's Curse on the he gets blown up. Now, Come With Me is fighting in all to them. There's gonna be the Mystic Flare. They have already got the kill onto the Storm Spear. Dirtua, he gets. Oh, he gets Cold Embrace here. So, Devorf is not able to do anything versus him. He's able to get out from here. He is gonna get followed by Bignum as well as Naomi. And they should be able to get the kill him in eventually, while PR is still diving behind it. Oh, J4 is just able to get away from Come With Me's avalanche touch, but he will still die.
Yeah, and Dicharra dies on the backside there by Bignum and the Witch Doctor. That was not so good for PR. They lost a tower on the bot lane. The top tier 2 is in deny range as well. And I think that Burden Unite is going to deny that up sooner rather than later. And Tiny, he's 3/4 of his way through an Aghanim Scepter as well. It's getting bad for PR right now. They need to get something done. They need to finish quickly before this Tiny gets out of control.
Indeed, he's just really getting items right now. Yeah, man, he's close to his Aghanims. 700 gold there. Cool. He's just gonna get harder and harder for PR in this sense. What does actually Jackal have? He still doesn't have that much. He's building up towards a Bloodstone right now, and he's not even really that close at the moment.
Yeah. Alright, the big man, Roshan. He's just sat there, he's minding his own business. Do you think that Burn United are going to be taking them soon? Because they're definitely asserting dominance around the map right now.
J4, he gets dusted. They know where he is. They should be able to toss him off in time. Yes, they are. Dirtua, he comes TPing in, but he should just run away because this is 5 versus 1. And he might just be a Bristleback, but that's not enough to survive versus 5 here.
Yeah, good point.
Mind Control just zoning him out. That's his entire team just... start to take the tower. Jackal is trying to split push a little bit here on bot, but not really doing enough damage towards the tower. Cheshire Cat is in mid. They're not able to push against an IO Tiny combination. They are able to get the mid tier 1 though. So far, a good trade here. While Burden is just start to lay in damage here on the top tier 2. They have to relocate out if Come With Me actually gets caught, or Big Man.
think they're going to chase. They have Winter's Curse, and he's decided against it. Yeah. I think the difference right now is the supports are more farmed on the side of Burn United, and Burn United supports do a lot more, I think, than PR supports. Like Winter Wyvern, for example, after that spells have been used, Winter Wyvern doesn't really do much after that. And J4 as well is just there for the pickoffs, and he doesn't really contribute much to team fights apart from the track gold. And but the Witch Doctor benefits so much from the gold, as well as the experience. And I think Burn United's are really, you know, the supports are keeping them in it.
As well as just covered me actually just getting so big already. There's just not really something that can withstand the tiny at the moment.
Yeah, they got the tree up now.
They got the glowing lava tree here, just ready to start slamming at people. Let's see, what does Minecraft? He's gonna build up for the Rot of Aoi here, Rot of Aethas. Start slowing, that's really strong versus the Bristleback. You're just able to guide him around all day long. They need the Surge then to keep him mobile.
Yeah, Dishonored's not too far off the BKB right now. The BKB is really essential, like the tiny combo as well as the Undying Decay. Oh, here we go now, so go on mid.
Yeah, Jekyll, he is found, he's gonna die. There's gonna be a Winter's Curse and he's just gonna get slapped a couple of times by Cone with me. He is able to survive through, there's gonna be the Mechanism as well. And he's just gonna try and transition this into a tier 2 here. Well, oh no, they actually find Gorek here. Combination of Avalanche Dust has been used, he's been able to survive through this, they're gonna be the orbs. And they just kill him off with the DK from Big Num here, mega kill streak. And now they start to go back into the tier 2 here.
Oh, and on the top lane, Cheshire Cat's pushing it out right now. I think they're gonna go for some sort of trade.
Well,
I don't think Cheshire Cat has the ability to
trade that effectively, no.
No.
He's able to lane some damage, but I don't think he's able to kill off everything before where Tiny has killed off your entire base.
Oh, definitely, especially with the overcharge from Wisp right now. Oh my god, he's chopping wood right now on this tower.
Yeah, the tower is already down, well, the top lane push has been given up. There's going to be a Mystic Flare in the back, though. They're able to survive through it for now. Well, actually, he's gonna die. Skyrim Mage is dead. Dirty Rap pops his BKB, starts running in after him. Come with me, he pulls back into the wall again. He's able to survive through with a Soul Rip here. There's gonna be the Death Warp coming out from Miami, able to zone them back. They just lost the Skyrim for at the moment. And Burden say, it's good. We're gonna go back. We get the tower.
Yeah, and there's a Bloodstone. Oh.
He is, however, he did get back there with Relocate, of course.
Bloodstone coming up right now on Jackal as well, and they're going to chase. I think they can afford to.
Yeah, they have vision on him. Yeah, come on with me, there's not something there which you can go into.
Yeah, he was like, fuck that, I ain't going back in there.
Yeah, that's a little bit too dangerous.
Yeah, just a little bit.
And at least a kind of a successful hold for PR. They did lose their tower here, so it's kind of open to relocate here if the creep wave gets pushed in. But kind of, they have to look out a little bit for that and make sure that there's someone there to defend it if needed then. Or just keep the creep wave out pushed at all times.
Yeah, in that fight, that soul rip saved Tiny's life there. I think that Tiny would have died.
Yeah.
Like, Tiny was really low and the mechanism coming out as well, I don't know who has the mechanism right now. Is it Undying? Yeah, Undying has the mechanism. As well as the Glimmer Cape, really safe come with me. He was going down. Oh, here we go. He's going to go on Jackal.
Yeah, they find him. There's going to be the Tusk as well. Ancient Seal, and they just kill him off. There's a Winter's Curse, though, but he's not able to really kill off anything. And now Gorek, he has to start TPing out, but they know where he is, so he's not really able to do this. And
he doesn't even have a TP.
He doesn't even have a TP. He's trying to maybe get something cheeky in the way of a deny on the...
Yeah.
On the creeps there on the jungle stack, but yeah, that doesn't work. And
now BU,
they're pinging out. They want to go for rush. The top lane is actually being pushed in right now with the Cheshire Cat creeps with the Iron Shell. They have the Medallion ready on Big Nun. And with the physical damage here from Kong with me, they are able to secure rush quite easily.
I'm not sure.
Well, even if they do know, or will they actually be in time? And they're missing the Winter's Curse for another 60 seconds. But even if they get here, it's not gonna be enough. Going with me. He is able to pick up the Aegis. He's building towards an AC right now. Still a little bit of a ways off there, but he's starting his build up towards it. And all day,
yeah.
And the trade for PR here was another 400-500 damage on the tier 3 on top. I think Bird and Unite are okay with this.
Yeah, and here we go, guys, looking at the gold and network graphs. PR is still winning in the XP department. I can't really, there we go, I can go on the gold graph now. And PR is still winning just about on the gold as well.
It's really, really even right now. Well, they're actually going to find two kills here for both sides. One, and now come with me, he's going to get changed out. There is going to be the death orb, but the vacuum wall, you're keeping everybody, they're killing them all. Nihis is getting low. Aegis has been popped. Bignum comes in here. They kill off Nihis. Bobby is able to blink backwards. Make Bignum. They're going to try and turn this one around. Two buybacks have been used already on the side of Burning United. Oh, Dirty Rai. He's just being left pretty much here with the Mystic Flare coming. Gorek. Is he able to TP out in time? Yes, he is.
There's a 2-for-1 there, and most ultimates were used by PR. And I think that Burning United can continue right now. That was really good vacuum wall there by Cheshire Cat.
Yeah, they need to get, for Burn United, they need to get out a little bit more from the buyback here.
Yeah, I agree there.
And with these open wrecks here, with no tier 3 defending it, they should be able to.
And no little bristle back either.
Oh, blink forward, coming. Avalanche Touch pull back actually now from Jekyll here. There's going to be the Glimmer Cape as well. Jekyll taking a lot of damage here from the Mystic Flare combination, but they do have the Glimmer Cape to keep him alive a little bit more there. And Komi is going to start laying in some damage here onto the Rex. Lee Rex down to half HP. They need to get this tower on time. Well, Jekyll goes in. Is he going to get Mind Control here? No, he gets an Ancient Seal off of him. There's going to be the wall back. And I think Burning are going to call this one a day and go back.
Yeah, I think that's really smart by Burn United. They don't want to advance too much with Ditchar coming back up now. Yeah, they just need to continue what they're doing. Just take a fight, take a Rosh. Exactly.
The thing though, the fight there was in favor of PR until the buybacks came out, and now they have buybacks on cooldown. So they do get the Rex for it, at least the melee Rex for now. Let's see, the gold and XP at 28 minutes now is just pretty much neglectable. But Gorek, he's taking off damage. Is he able to get off the Cold Embrace? He is not.
No.
He's gonna take a fall, and it gives Steiny his level 16 here. Or actually, he already had it.
Yeah, they've really gotta wait for Jackal to really get online. Just the Bloodstone is not doing him justice at all. It's only 28 minutes in, everyone's playing really well. I just think that Jackal needs that extra item. That
he needs
that
BKB to survive through it as well.
Yeah, that's also a game-changing item.
Oh, he's actually found here. There's going to be the Avalanche, there's going to be the Toss, there's going to be the Relocate in, but it's already too late. They're not able to get the Skywrath Ancient Seal on top of him, and while they're all here, they're just going to go for the...
For the range barracks, yeah.
Doing right, a lot of damage.
If Ditchara can do anything about it. Oh, that's very rude of Ditchara, just throwing out the snot on the big rock. You shouldn't do that.
There is the Solar Crest on him as well, so he's able to live through quite effectively. Well, Gorek, he's just going to take a fall here. Ditchara is going strong. He has his BKB popped. Mind Control is... Gonna get focus here by Jekyll. Is he able to kill off Jekyll? No, he's not. He's gonna die here first. And now, come with me, says hello, Dirty Ryan. Dirty Ryan says, I don't want anything to do with this, and runs away from him. Come with me, walks back into the base, and he's just gonna start slamming on this range rack. And it's gonna take a fall here. He needs one more slap. He gets it. That's gonna be the range racks.
Yeah, I think Tiny really needs a BKB. I think it's quite important he gets one as well. Like, in these fights, he's getting pulled around, kited around by this Winter Wyvern and the Darkseer. And I think in that fight, if Winter Wyvern was alive at the start with that Winter's Curse, I think they would have won that fight.
They could have won the fight, yeah, but still.
Yeah, it was really convincing.
Still, and good fight Cheshire from Burden. They get the Rex there, so.
Cheshire Cat has been playing outstandingly. Like, these vacuum walls, these have been on point every single time. Yeah, go, go, Power Rangers. That's what I'm saying, man. Come on, PR. I've got a bet on. Let's do it. Come on, PR.
And Yeah, we're actually we already have the Death Ward up with the Aghanims as well on Miami. If we can get off like a big Death Ward here without, well, actually the Golden Rage won't help them that much anymore because it will just bounce off to everybody else.
Oh yeah, Witch Doctor really farmed as well. Burn United have been playing outstandingly as well. Tiny's just been picking up the farm around the map as. And we got the Solar Crest up on Undying. That's a really smart pickup, especially against heroes like, you know, Bristleback, as well as the Bounty Hunter. It's beyond me who's going to win at this stage. I believe that Wisp and Tiny are definitely strong right now. Those two are like, you know, I don't know, Apple and Crumble. They just go together like anything.
Like fish and chips.
Like fish and chips. I'm English. Fish and chips are bae. Let's see what happens.
Going with me, he's gonna go for a moon shard here. That's gonna be fun. Seeing that item, it's gives him a shitload of attack speed. Like if you get close to him, you're just gonna get punched down all the way through. No way to stand against that. He's gonna find Dirty Raw here. Dirty Raw pops a BKB. He's trying to get out from here, and he will be able to due to the fact that there was gonna be the Winter's Curse. And they blow up knees here, but now Gorak is stuck. He's gonna get wind. Oh man, he's just gonna die here. The Rot of Atos keeps slowing him down so much.
Unstoppable. Big Numb playing so well on this Undying. I'm not sure if that was a KS or something with the decay, but he's still.
Doesn't
playing
matter.
Really
they get
well.
The kill. They don't care. Yeah. They just wanna get the kills. They wanna destroy them.
I think there's tier 2 on the top lane is going down. Burn United looking very strong right now in 32 minutes in. 21-26 towards Burn. Yeah, no, just...
Oh, there's going to be the blink in. Pokon with me is laying down a lot of damage. Jukras already has to go back while Jekka goes into straight into the enemy team. He's able to not find anybody so far. Well, he's actually going to get start slapping down. Pokon with me is taking a lot of damage here. And they kill off J4 with the Skywrath Mage. And now they're gonna go high ground again.
It's not looking good for PR right now. I think that a second more barracks is going down.
If they're gonna lose another Rex here, this might just be the game for Burden here. And Jekyll, he goes in. He just gets silenced up straight away though. There's gonna be Mystic Flare. He's getting total combination on top of him and die. Cheshire Cat, he's walking here. Come with me, doesn't care. He just wants to go for the Rex. Have fun walking around here, Dirty. But yeah, go after knees. He's gonna be back into his base in 1 second anyway. All the damage done for nothing. And now Kobe, he starts slapping a little bit onto the other people right now. Miami, he just TP's back. No way to stop it by Dirty Rock.
Yeah, the Solar Crest then. The debuff on Dijarahi, he missed two attacks on the Witch Doctor then. Probably would have killed Witch Doctor. So Dijarahi, very unlucky there. But just well played by... Witch Doctor, he's just got that TP just in time.
And man, it was just another good fight as well as a Rex taken for Burden. It's gonna be tough to defend versus these two lanes of creeps that keep on pushing in. And with Rush up now, Burden should be able to get it and then just go for the end push. Just look at this. This is just a downside battle. Just look at the graph going down. Networth. Well over 4k, it should be nearing the 6k mark, maybe even the 8. Well, the XP actually is gonna be stagnating around the 0 mark here.
And here we go, come with me, just slapping the big man right in the face. What's his attack speed? 0.47, come with me, just being amazing on this Tiny right now. Last game he didn't play too well on the Enchantress, maybe the circumstances of his lane, etc. But recent, come with me, just playing amazing.
They have the gem ready as well. Who actually purchased it? It's on Might Control here. Well, oh, come with me. He's just going in aggressively. He doesn't care. Well, Jekka goes into the backline. He finds Big Numb. There's going to be the Winter's Curse on my own, but they're not able to kill him just yet. He's still alive. Wall is there. Are they going to get the good vacuum of it? So far, I haven't seen it being used. So they're just still surviving. One for one trade at the moment. It's just a Dark Seer as well. Oh, now they find Mind Control here as well. He's gonna die. Jekyll's gonna die. Go with me. He's slapping away. Three people dead. Are they gonna find Dirty Raw here as well? Toss on top of him. The zombie is still following him, keeping on vision as well as the Solar Crest on him. They're gonna keep on following him. Do they have an Avalanche? Do they have a toss? They will have it soon. No way Dirty Raw is gonna survive from this. There you
There's
go. There's
eight
the toss.
Cool eight cool stacks. I'll come with me then. Oh.
He doesn't care.
He's still alive there. And here we go. They're just gonna backdoor.
They're just gonna relocate him. Well, Cheshire Cat, he walks in. He's actually able to dodge the Avalanche. He just killing me is here, but come with me. Well, Cheshire Cat, Darkseer, versus Tiny, come with me. The end is Cheshire Cat. He's just running circles around him. He's dropping down a mechanism. It gets destroyed. This is GG end, I call it. They're just trying to keep going with me of the Rex by dropping his items, but to no avail at all.
Oh god, that was funny.
Oh, there was a funny play there coming out from it. But Burden, they get the second match in this best of three. We're gonna go the full way here. The winner of this best of three in this show match organized by Esports Against Addictions. Well, let's see who's gonna be the winner of this. We're gonna play the commercials and we'll be back soon.